Hey guys, this is ShowKirby707, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. In the last part, we completed the cable ordeals. And, well, we pretty much have all collectibles. We have all pulses, all heart pieces, and, yeah. We're pretty much well prepared. So, yeah, nothing else for us to do in Hyrule but go to... Well, I can't go to first person view. Go to Hyrule Castle. Anyways, let's head on through. And how appropriate is that nighttime? Well, sort of-ish. Anyways, as we approach the barrier that's surrounding Hyrule Castle, it looks pretty at nighttime, by the way. I kind of like the cutscene during nighttime. It's different. Anyways, now that we defeated Zant, we have all the fused shadows, and... Well, let's just say Midna will do her thing. Oh boy, this is getting exciting! This is gonna get exciting! Or not. That's gotta hurt for Midna. Ow! Ouch! Poor Midna. Midna, you're gonna be okay? Midna, can you hear me? Give me a sign that you're okay? A rumble? Okay, that's a sign. Alrighty then, well... Yeah, Midna is freakishly scary, big tarantula thing. That's, I don't know why, but I find it very creepy that Midna transformed to that thing. I don't know, it just reminds me of tarantula. But anyways, with this power, Midna stabs the barrier, and with that, it destroys it. Good job, Midna! Alright! Hey, Midna, you okay? That must have been some heavy lifting work, wasn't it? You okay? Yeah, you're fine. Anyways, the barrier's broken, and now, Hyrule Castle's open for us to go to. And by the way, I like the rain. Little atmosphere in the game. It's not thundering and what the heck is going on right there? Okay, graphical issues. Anyways, now the way is open, we can now proceed on to Hyrule Castle. And it's a nice little atmosphere to Hyrule Castle. It's raining, but there's no music. I kind of like that atmosphere. It's different. But I like when you broke the barrier, they play the Hyrule music. Hyrule Castle music from Link to the Past. Anyways, welcome to Hyrule Castle. I have to say, I love this Hyrule Castle. It's massive. It's freakishly huge. And pretty at the same time. It's nice. And by the way, I know it was nighttime when we first entered Castle Town. But, but for some reason, it's daytime and raining. But once you leave this area, it won't be raining. It'll be the way where you first came into Castle Town. But anyways, we got two ways we can go to. Well, actually three. We can go left, middle, or right. You know what? I'm gonna start with the left. I like going clockwise. Well, at least mostly clockwise. But anyway, let's go on this side. Because we got a few enemies and some Kagrok that want to play. Alrighty. There we go. So yeah, with a great spin, these guys are no match. Yeah, just instant kill with these Bokoblins. So these Bokoblins are a little bit stronger than the blue ones, so yeah. Alright, if I remember correctly, I believe... Am I in the right section? It doesn't matter how what order I'm doing it. But yeah, it's a nice little atmosphere that there's no music. It's raining. It's different, so... I keep saying that for the millionth time already, but it's... Oh, shoot! Crap, no, don't shoot, dear! I want to keep all my hearts. No, sorry, and I can't... No, I missed. Dang it. I was trying to do ending blow on him, or finishing blow, or whatever the move is called. To stab you. Is there another one here? I could just wonder, like, another... Oh, yeah, there's one there. Actually, no, I don't want to shoot him. Let's just attack these guys, because I don't feel like... I don't feel like pulling my bow out. Oh, I hear more. Yeah! Great spin instantly kills him. I mean, it's great. It feels awesome to use the great spin. So, yeah, I try to keep my health caught that fool, so yeah. Alrighty. So anyways, in this part of the castle, we need to break through these fences. But we cannot break them with bombs or our head if we try to roll into them. And if you guys remember in the Gerudo Desert, you know what creature breaks them? Boars. So we have some boars in the back here. And, well, they can crash into pretty much mostly anything, including these towers, so that's really awesome. But just watch out for the bombs, because, well, that'll hurt. That'll hurt a lot. Well, I'm not sure about Link, but it'll hurt the boar, which is kind of sad, actually. Because boars, they don't really do anything to us. They're helpful. They're helpful little creatures. Okay, they're not little. And I did not mean to attack that guy. Alrighty, then. Okay. Seems like the right way to go to, but let me attack this guy first. I don't want you shooting at me, buddy. Go away. Hey, I got an arrow. Awesome. Alright, so anyways, in this portion... For some reason, it stops raining. Weird. Okay, anyways, in this portion, there is actually... something, a marking on the ground. You want to kind of target this to get rid of the leaves. It doesn't really do much if you target, I don't know, 5 times, because they'll still get rid of at least one pile of leaves. And once you do that, Midna will say something. Let's talk to Midna.
Aren't you curious what's on the other side of this wall, Link? There might be a way in. Want to check it out?
That is a hint that there might be something on the other side, but we will check that clear this puzzle. So anyways, if you look in the marking on the ground, it should take a Triforce, but the green lines represent some kind of S or Z, or pretty much an S. So it's like a zigzag line. So you start from the top, then that way, this way, that way. So pretty much in a zigzag order. Okay then. Is this the top? I believe this is the top. So I believe we want to target this, and then this, and then across. So zigzag, which way do we go now? I believe we go this way, I believe. I believe that's right, I think. Alright? No? Okay. I don't know why, but I always have issues with this. I think I'm doing it right, right? That should, or maybe it's backwards, maybe it's backwards. Maybe you start from here, then you go on your way to the point. Maybe that's the order. Okay, let's try that. I think this is the right way. Huh? Wait, what? Wait. Okay, that didn't work apparently. What the heck, game? I did the right order, right? 1, 2, 3. Yeah, there's 4 points. Huh? Or maybe it's the other way around. Maybe let's try this way instead. Let's try this way. I have no idea. I think this is wrong. Or maybe right. I don't know. What the heck? Okay. No, because this is the point. Because this is only 1 point. Yeah, because this is shaped like a triangle. So this should be the right way. 1, 2, 3, or maybe it's this one. No, it should be the middle one. It should be the middle, because it goes down the middle, right? It should be that way. 2, 3. There we go! I tried that the first time! How come it didn't work the first time? The game is very picky. This game is very picky on your targets. Alright, well, aside from that hassle, we got the dungeon map. Alright, it's alright. Dungeon maps are always helpful, sometimes. So anyways, remember what Minda said about checking on the other side? Well, how about we check on the other side? You don't have to do it. It's an optional area that you can explore, but I might as well go through it. I mean, it's I actually like this optional area. It's actually pretty neat. So anyways, we're in more rain, and it seems a little bit darker than what we were in. So yeah, this is another secret area that you can come into. First of all, I want to transform into normal, because, well, we got Army of the Dead. Okay, not really Army of the Dead, but you get the point. So yeah, we got some stall children, and Yeah, these annoying little buggers. And we got Stouffles, and I got bombs here. So let's just bomb this guy real quick and just defend ourselves. Alright, hi guy, how's it going? I would use a mortal draw on you, but I'm afraid I'll get blasted by the bomb. Okay. We do have lit unlit torches here, but you cannot light them right now because it is raining. So if you try to light them up, the rain will just douse it out. So there's no way you can light those torches. You have to do something about the rain first. Alright, but anyways, I think there's more Stouffle children. I'm not sure. No, there's more Stouffles though. I remember that. But I don't know about the... No, I think we got rid of all the Stall children. Let's just get rid of these Stouffles first. Yeah, I see one over there. Ha ha ha! Sucks to be you. Alright, and let's place one right here. Hey, how's it going? He just looked for a moment, then kablooey, he just exploded. Alright, so anyway, there's a couple of things that we can explore. There's a couple of tombstones that have messages on them. It says, the cursed swordsman sleeps before the sacred tree. Alright. And another one over here says, in the land where the rain stops, the statue of time moves. So these are actually hints to what you need to do in this area. Now the first one said the sleeping soldier is underneath the sacred tree. Well, you don't see anybody, but if you put your senses on, there are some dead soldiers, and they are pointing towards this bombable rock. They look kind of creepy, to be honest. Yeah, they look really creepy. I don't know why, but their faces look really creepy. I would not like to see that when I wake up in the morning. I would not like to see that. No way. Alright, anyway, so they're pointing to this rock over here. And once we explode it, there is a switch. And this switch will unlock that gate. So, we're pretty much almost done with this area. It's a very short optional area. You don't have to do this, but it can be very helpful toward the end of this, I guess, supposedly dungeon. Anyway, we got an orange rupee, but... Oh, actually, we have enough for it. Okay, nice. I mean, I don't really need money at this point. Unless you want to save it for... A green rupee? Really? Really, game? You're gonna put that in a chest? Really? I could find more green rupees in a bush. Alright, 23 is not that bad. Alright, so anyways, we do have a lantern oil that you can actually refill your lantern oil with, or lantern, and fill it with more oil. So that seems really, what'd you call it? Oh my god. Cool, I guess. Alright, anyway, there's actually on the lantern post, what this does is stop the rain, but temporary. So what you need to do is actually sprint toward the other side, where the gates are closed, where you see the unlit torches over here. So since it stopped raining, we can light these up. But the rain will be out temporary. So that's why you need to hurry. And since we lit these... Okay, I thought they were gonna stay lit, but I guess not. But yeah, that was close. But anyways, now that we lit the torches, I don't know why I went around, we have some owl statues. Yay! More use of the Dominion Rod! Yay! So you're probably wondering where we take the the statues at. Well, there's some indentations on the ground over here that you can put the statues at. So anyways, you will put the statues over here. So that's one of them. And then we need to go on the get the other statue and put this statue on the other indentation. Or the other hole, rather. Alright. You don't have to do this area, but if you want a really nice, I guess nice rewards, plural rewards, at the end of this dungeon, you might as well go through this area. It can be very helpful if you're low on items, like, if you're low on bombs or arrows, then it might be useful, so yeah. But I mean, before you come to this area, you should be prepared, because you might need them, so I don't see the... I mean, it's not really the most useful thing to do, or... You don't have to do this room, it's optional, but I might as well do it. And plus, I like this area, though. I don't know why. I like the atmosphere. Anyways, if you open this chest, we get a small key. Now, technically, you could go to the middle door right now since you have a small key. And what do you want, Minna? You got everything you can out here. Now get to the castle through the front door. Alright. Linda is actually right. You can go through the front door of the castle since we have a small key now. But we haven't exactly explored the right side of Hyrule Castle just yet. So yeah, technically right now you could go to the front entrance of the castle and enter. But I want to explore a little bit more of the castle. So yeah. Alright, anyways, we got some guys back, of course. I need a boar, that's for sure. You know what? I'm gonna shoot that guy and then just ride a boar out of here. Like, luckily he doesn't see me, so I can just snipe at him. There we go. Alright, any more guys? Oh, there's one more. You know what? I'm gonna shoot you down. There we go. It's nice shooting at bulblins when they're in towers. It's nice to shoot them. Wait, can I get on you? Can I get on? There we go. Alright. So we're done with this area. Now, let's go to the right side. I mean, if you want to skip the right side, go right ahead. Feel free to do it. But I'm going to explore Hyrule Castle. Because this is such a nice area. So, it's nice to explore this castle. I mean, this is the last area that you go to in this game. And, well, you won't... Well, technically, you can come here anytime after... Well, after you beat this game. So, you can come back here anytime you want to. Because it's technically the last area of the game. So, yeah. Anyways, we do have the key to go to that front door, but we're gonna go there later. So, I want to explore the right side of the castle. But, in the next part. So, next time on... Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god, that scared me! Oh, I knew a cockroach was gonna go after me when I end the episode, but gee, that scared the crap out of me. That kind of gave me a jump scare. Alright, I don't want any more cockroaches after me. Hopefully not. At least off screen, hopefully not, because I want to keep all my hearts up. Anyways, with my outro, we are done with this episode. So next time on The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, we will explore the right side of the castle. And then make our way inside it. So, I will see you guys then. So, this is Shadow Kirby 707 saying, bye.